Today, Holy Thursday, we gather to commemorate the institution of the ministerial priesthood and of the Eucharist, the two sacraments which perpetuate in a unique manner the endless love of Christ for all mankind. When he ordered his apostles to repeat what he did at the Last Supper, Jesus became even more God with us in the person of the ordained minister, and by making himself bread and wine to be our food and drink for our earthly pilgrimage. Let our participation in the holy sacrifice this evening and the adoration that will follow it be for all of us a special opportunity to thank the Lord for the gifts of the ministerial priesthood and of the Eucharist. Please stand.
Glory in the cross of Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, tonight we begin the Paschal Triduum, the Passion, Death, and Resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. On this most solemn hour, Jesus left us a memorial of two symbolic gestures of his love for us, the giving of his own body and blood in the form of bread and wine, and his act of washing the feet of his disciples. These two remind us that the supreme act of love is manifested through total self-giving of oneself for the beloved, just as what Jesus did when he freely offered his life on the cross for our sake, and to challenge us to strip away our clothes of self-entitlement, honors, and pride, and to serve one another out of love for each other and out of love for God. And so we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Let us acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and mercy. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Oh,
Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated. The Passover reminds the Jews of God, delivering the Israelites from slavery in Egypt. God has brought us a new Passover through Jesus. Rising from death to life, Jesus has let us pass over from sin to grace.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old, male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. And then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night, I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessing cup is a communion. How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? the cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosened my bonds. Offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people. Blessing Kabisa Communion.
Paul passes on the tradition of the new Passover of Jesus. In the Eucharist, Jesus himself becomes the sacrificial lamb whose body and blood are offered for our salvation.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed unto you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it, and said, This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, also the cup, after the supper, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
I give you a new commandment, says the Lord. Love one another as I have loved you.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with a towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Please be seated.
Good afternoon. Magandang hapon po sa lahat. Pakibati yung ating katabi na kanina pang pinagpapawisan. Good afternoon. May isang nanay na ginising ang kanyang anak. Sabi niya, "Anak, magsisimula na ang misa. Pumunta ka na sa simbahan. Linggo ngayon. Tumayo-tayo ka na dyan." Sabi ng anak, "Tinatamad pa ako, nay. Gusto ko pa magpahinga." Ikalawa, "Ayaw ako ng mga tao dun sa simbahan. Ayaw nila akong makita." Nagalit yung nanay. Sabi niya, "Nako anak, tumayo ka na dyan. Pumunta ka na sa simbahan sa dalawang kadahilanan. Una, 60 years old ka na. 60 ka na. At ikalawa, ikaw ang parish priest ng simbahang iyon." Mga kaibigan, mga kapatid, sa araw na ito, inaalala natin ang pagtatag ng ating Panginoong Hesukristo sa dalawang mahalagang sakramento ng simbahan, the Holy Eucharist, the Mass, and the Holy Orders. For short, pwede natin sabihin, pagpapari, kasama siyempre sa Holy Orders, ang obispo, pari, at diakono. Without the priest, there is no Eucharist. Kaya, laging magkaugnay ang dalawang sakramentong ito. Pero pansin niyo mga kapatid, sino ba ang dapat maging pari? Sa huling hapunan, nung itinatag ng ating Panginoon ang Eucharistia, kung babasahin natin ang Biblia, maraming accounts, kasama pa si Judas. Ibig sabihin mga kapatid, si Judas ay pari pa rin, depende sa interpretation. Pwede bang sabihin natin, may Judas din pala sa mga pari? Ibig sabihin, ang mga pari ay hindi perpekto, tulad ng 12 disipulo ni Kristo. Anong klaseng pari ba ang gusto natin? Siguro sasabihin natin, yung banal na pari. Ideally, yung matalinong pari, wish ko lang. Yung gwapong pari, tumingin na lang po kayo sa likuran ko. Mamili kayo at kayong sumagot kung tama ba ang pinili nyo. Alam nyo, kahit anong gawin natin, ang mga pari ay tao pa rin. Marami tayong makikita, mga kahinaan, may pipintas sa mga pari. Tulad ng 2 bata na sinabihan ng pari, o magpari kayo ha, paglaki nyo. Sabi ng isang bata, ayoko magpari kasi yung mga pari, B-O-B-O. B-O-B-O, ayoko sabihin. O ba't mo naman nasabi yan? Kasi yung mga pari, araw-araw nagmimisa. Lagi naman nagbabasa. Hindi na memorize yung misa. Ang tatanda na nga, hindi pa memorize. At sabi naman ng isa, ay yung pari namin madamot. Kasi pagdating sa misa, siya lang yung kumakain ng malaking hostya. Binibigay sa mga tao, maliliit ang damot. At saka, siya lang ang may iniinom, kami wala. Sabi nila, alak daw yun. Kaya yung pari namin madamot. Minsan din, ang pari ay may karanasan kung paano maging pari sa mga bata, sa mga tao. Kami dito sa Manaoag ay merong First Communion. Last March 2, nagpa-First Communion kami. More than 1,000. Bago yun, nagpa-kumpisal kami mga pari. Tulong-tulong kami, more than 1,000 ang aming nabigyan ng First Communion. Meron pang susunod. At ang ganda po ng paghanda ng ating mga katikista doon sa kanilang pagkomunyon. Meron silang guide for communion. At ito yung sinasabi ng mga bata, lalo na mga grade 3 ito. Template na po ito. Bendisyonan niyo po ako, Padre, sapagkat ako po ay nagkasala. Ito po ang aking unang pangungumpisal. At ito po ang aking mga kasalanan. Ang cute pakinggan pag bata nagsasabi nun. Pero ilang beses ito ang karanasan ko sa pagpapakumpisal sa mga bata. Ito yung sinasabi pa iba-ibang pagkakataon. Bendisyonan niyo po ako, Padre, sapagkat kayo po ay nagkasala. Ang galing naman ng bata, alam na makasalanan ako. At ito po ang aking unang pag-uumpisa. Galing niya naman, nag-umpisa na siya. At ito po ang inyong mga kasalanan. Kaya minsan tinitingnan ko yung kopya ng mga bata. Ano kayang kasalanan kung nakasulat doon? Alam na anam niya. Anong uri ng pari ang gusto natin? Minimithin natin. May nakita ako, common na ito sa mga pari, ibabahagi ko lang sa inyo. Hindi buo. Isang sulat, katha, o article ng title is, The Priest is Always Wrong. Pag pinaayos ng pari ang simbahan, magastos siya. Pag hindi niya pinaayos, hinahayaan niya masira o mabulok ang simbahan niya. Kung kasama niya lagi ang mga kababaihan, playboy siya. Pag mga lalaki, bading siya. Pag mga bata, pedophilia siya. Pag mga manang, matatandang babae, mama's boy siya. Pag mga lalaki naman, magikero siya. Pag lumayo siya sa kanila, masungit siya. Pag matagal siya sa pagpapakumpisal, mabagal siya. Pag mabilis naman, nagmamadali siya. Pag malakas ang boses niya, sumisigaw siya, galit siya. Pag mahina naman, hindi siya maintindihan. Pag humingi siya ng limos o kontribusyon, mukha siyang pera. Pag hindi naman, mayabang siya. Ayaw niya ng tulong ng mga tao. Pag batang pari, walang karanasan. Pag matanda na, mag-retire na sana siya. Pag mahilig siya sa social media, updated sa technology, at sa gadgets, siya ay materialistic. Pag nahuhuli sa gadgets, siya ay Jurassic. Pag siya ay may sariling sasakyan, siya ay makamundo. Pag wala siyang sasakyan, siya ay wala sa uso. Hanggat buhay ang pari, maraming masasabi, maraming makikita sa kanya. Pero pag namatay ang pari, walang gustong pumasok sa seminaryo, walang gustong pumalit sa kanya. Kung may kukunin po sa amin sa araw na ito, sino pong gustong palitan nyo? Para sa akin mga kapatid, hindi talaga kailangan na ang pari ay perpekto o banal. Makakatulong. Sapagkat lalo na sa misa, ang ibinibigay ng pari ay hindi ang katawan niya. Ang binibigay ng pari ay katawan ni Kristo. Kaya hindi kayo makakarinig ng pari magsasabi, my body, my body, my body. Kundi body of Christ, body of Christ. Ang binibigay ng pari, hindi ang pag-ibig niya, kundi ang pag-ibig ni Kristo. Ang binibigay ng pari, hindi lang ang sarili niya, kundi ang buong simbahan. Sapagkat kapag ka nakakita na yun ng pari, makikita natin na siya ang tumatayong tanda ng Diyos na nagtitiwala sa taong mahina. God still believes in weak, imperfect men, wounded men like the priests. The priest is the sign of hope for his people. Sapagkat ang pari ay kaisa, kasama, isa sa simbahan. Kaya nga pagsimula ng misa, ang sinasabi ng pari, I confess, kasama siya. Ang pari ay hindi banal, hindi santo, makasalanan, tulad nyo, tulad ko. Lahat sa simbahan, sa misa, sa Eucharistia, may pag-asa tayo. Sabihan nyo po yung katabi mo ngayon. Kapatid, kahit ganyan, ang mukha mo, alam ko, ikaw, minsan, ay demonyo, pero tulad ng pari, may pag-asa tayo. This is what we celebrate. The God who dies, who believes in each one of us.
Please remain seated for the washing of the feet. May the reenactments of the washing of the feet of the apostles serve as a reminder for us to love one another as the Lord has commanded us to do.
as I have done for you.
Thank you.
Please stand.
At the Last Supper, Jesus gave to us the Eucharist as the memorial of his death and resurrection. Let us pray to the Father that we may live the mystery which the Eucharist signifies. We pray, Lord, listen to your people.
Lord, listen to your people. That the Church may live and celebrate the Eucharist as the continuation of the Lord's presence, their nourishment on their journey to the Father, and a pledge and foretaste of heaven, we pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
That Pope Francis, bishops, priests, and deacons may find in the Eucharist the consolation to bear their suffering and the courage to remain faithful, we pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
That those in authority may follow the example of the Lord Jesus, who chose to serve rather than to be served, and to give his life for the good of the people, we pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
That the sick and infirm may find solace and healing in the Eucharist, and that we may be delivered from any kind of disease, we pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
That the faithful departed, who partook of the Lord's body and blood, come at last to eternal life promised in the Eucharist, we pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
We pray for the urgent concerns of our community, the intentions offered in this Mass, and for our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
Lord, each time we celebrate the memorial of your cross in this Eucharist, we announce your return in glory. Bring us to that day when we will be one with you forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For He is the true and eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer Himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as His memorial. As we eat His flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink His blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Socrates, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants who have gone from this world and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysonogus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, a command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants have gone from this world, who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Athanasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Please stand.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign, forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
please kneel.
Behold Jesus, the High Priest, the loving priest, the model priest, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Please kneel.
est et fides supem in tu, sensum defectui. Genitori, genitoque, laus et juvenis,